Ah yes, the good old days, when the FAA's word was as good as gold. But in the wake of the MAX crisis, those days seem to be long gone. EASA, the European Union Aviation Safety Agency, told members of the European Parliament this week that from now on, it's going to take more than just the word of the FAA before they will certify new U.S. aircraft to occupy the skies of the European Union. That's next on Maximus. The European Union Aviation Safety Agency says it plans to change the way it certifies aircraft manufactured in the United States, citing the long-established process of trusting the FAA's recommendations for the certification of U.S. aircraft and its products. EASA said it will assert a more independent role in determining their airworthiness. The newly announced procedure emerges as a result of the many lessons learned from the crashes and worldwide grounding of the Boeing 737 MAX aircraft, EASA's executive director Patrick Kai said. Speaking to the European Parliament's Transport Committee on Monday, Kai said that a long-standing bilateral safety agreement between the EU and the US, which has been in place since May of 2011, resulted in progressively less and less involvement from EASA on FAA-approved projects. Given the tragedies and what happened, he noted, referring to the lack of oversight of the FAA in certifying the MAX-8 and -9, we have stopped this trend and will increase our level of involvement and our level of independent review of U.S. projects in order to build our own safety assessments. The change, he said, will apply to U.S. products in particular, but also to aerospace products developed in Canada and Brazil, two countries with whom the EU also maintains a bilateral safety agreement. Kai acknowledged that the new approach of independently assessing and analyzing safety-critical components and systems of future aircraft first certified by aviation safety regulators in the U.S., Brazil, and Canada will require more effort, but give reassurance to European citizens that we are performing our work as the safety regulator in Europe. European Parliament's Transport Committee requested the hearing with Kai in response to reports that EASA will likely recertify the 737 MAX 8 and 9 later this week, allowing the Boeing aircraft to return to service in the European Union. Although he repeated earlier statements that he believes the aircraft is indeed fit to fly safely, he did not provide a firm date for the ungrounding, saying only that EASA would become the next authority to follow certification by the U.S., Brazil, and Canada. The FAA, Brazil's National Civil Aviation Agency, Transport Canada, and EASA have done most of the technical work involved in MAX's recertification, Kai said. He added that he understands Chinese authorities continue performing their own work on certifying the MAX in China. However, he said, we have no visibility on when and how they will return the MAX to service. On November 24th last year, EASA issued a proposed airworthiness directive for EU airlines and a safety directive for third country operators aiming to deploy the MAX in the EU. A public comment period that closed on December 22nd received 38 comments, most of them relating to the wording and clarification of the text of the directive. A document with responses to those questions will be published at the same time the final airworthiness directive is issued. Also, EASA has been coordinating with the national aviation authorities of the EU on the work they need to perform to support the MAX's re-entry into service. That work mainly involves the oversight of the pilot training activities and the implementation of the technical changes as mandated by EASA on each grounded MAX. All this is expected to take place later this week, Kai said. Another lesson from the MAX accidents center on a larger focus of human interaction factors during the certification process. Our human factor experts will intervene as early as possible in the design of the architecture of the aircraft in order to make sure that the operational feeling and the training requirement of pilots are properly taken into account, according to Kai. So there you have it. Due to the FAA's massive oversight failure in the MAX program, as well as other massive aviation oversight failures, world regulators will no longer be greenlighting the FAA's future recommendations without a thorough examination process of their own before allowing new U.S. aircraft to fly in the skies over Europe and other countries. Well, that's all I have for now. What do you think? Let me know down below. And as always, before you go, please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and ring the bell so you can be notified whenever we release new content. And remember, leave the rubber on the runway and your troubles on the ground. And I will see you next time in the air. Yeah, this is Maximus.